Welcome to Pharmacology by Lecturio. I'm Dr. Praveen J. Shukla. We're going to be going over inflammation and the drugs that we use to mitigate it. Okay, guys, we're going to do a really complicated graphic. It's going to take us about 5 minutes, but what I'm going to do in the next 5 minutes is summarize an entire 3-month course in inflammation. So let's start with a stimulus. This stimulus affects the cell membrane. It disturbs it somehow. Well, your cell membrane, don't forget, is made up of a whole bunch of phospholipids. Now, these phospholipids conveniently are precursors to many of the signals that we have for inflammation. So the phospholipids have arachidonic acid enmeshed within them. And this arachidonic acid is broken down by phospholipase A2. Now, it makes sense that the first step of inflammation is inhibition. The first step that we can use to inhibit inflammation is inhibiting that phospholipase A2. We do that with phospholipase inhibitors and with corticosteroids. Let's move on to the arachidonic acid. Now, arachidonic acid is also going to be brought about in increasing levels with a high-fat acid diet. So if we theoretically substitute a high-fat diet with a low fatty acid substitution diet, we may be able to reduce the levels of arachidonic acid in our body. That's the theory behind, let's call it a naturopathic movement, to have a fatty acid substitution diet to reduce inflammation. Unfortunately, it doesn't work as well in the real world as we would have thought. Now, from arachidonic acid, we develop leukotrienes. Okay, what's a leukotriene? A leukotriene is a complex molecule that's broken down from arachidonic acid by lipoxygenases. Now, to stop that process, we can use lipoxygenase inhibitors. Leukotrienes have many subtypes, and they come with letter alphanumeric designations that are sometimes quite confusing, and really, you don't have to memorize the different types of leukotrienes for your exams. I think the most important idea is to recognize that arachidonic acid forms leukotrienes. Now, these leukotrienes alter the way the blood vessels work. They alter what's called vascular permeability. They also work in lung bronchi, so they alter bronchial constriction, and they also cause an increased secretion of mucus. So you can see just in your own mind how this can be very useful in asthma. Now, if you go back to your asthma lectures, we talk about leukotriene antagonists as being almost as effective as steroids. Now, bronchospasm, congestion, and mucus plugging occur with excess leukotrienes, so a leukotriene antagonist will help prevent that. Other things that are brought about from arachidonic acid include things like prostacyclin and thromboxane, and of course the prostaglandins. Now, the prostaglandins and the leukotrienes are kind of two sides of the seesaw that go back and forth, and they help mitigate inflammation in the cells that we talked about with the leukotrienes. Cyclooxygenase is the enzyme that takes arachidonic acid and turns it into any one of those other molecules, but not leukotrienes. So this is an important point. Cyclooxygenase turns arachidonic acid into prostacyclin, thromboxane, or a prostaglandin. Lipoxygenase turns arachidonic acid into one of the leukotrienes. Now, it seems that we need a stop point for cyclooxygenase, and it is, you guessed it, aspirin. So aspirin is a cyclooxygenase inhibitor. That's how it works to reduce inflammation, because it prevents the formation of those three agents. Now, thromboxane is particularly important with leukocyte modulation. Therefore, inflammation of a certain type is mediated through thromboxane. Now let's talk about one of the types of leukotrienes. It's leukotriene B4. Leukotriene B4 is responsible for phagocyte attraction and activation. Phagocytes, if you remember, are those white blood cells that eat up other organisms. Now, leukotriene mediation can be blocked right at the receptor site by receptor antagonists. So you can have leukotriene B4 antagonist, you can have leukotriene C4 or C2 or D4 or E4. It doesn't matter what type of leukotriene. For almost every leukotriene, we've developed a receptor antagonist for it. The one that I think you're probably the most familiar with are the ones that are working in the lungs. Now, remember that leukotriene B4 is involved in a different kind of inflammatory response as the leukotrienes that are in the other category. So I've separated them out, and we're going to talk about them separately later. Colchicine blocks that leukotriene B4 inflammation. Remember that word, colchicine. Okay, so I'm really proud of you. You managed to make it through a 3-month pharmacology of inflammation lecture in 5 minutes. Let's move on to a specific group of anti-inflammatory agents called non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agents. So these are a class of drugs that work through the cyclooxygenase pathway. The non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agents can include aspirin. They include other non-selective non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agents like ibuprofen, which is commonly sold as Advil. And we have specific cyclooxygenase type 2 inhibitors like selexisib. We have other types of anti-inflammatory drugs. They're called the DMARDs, disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs. So they can be cytotoxic, they can work on T lymphocyte activity or B lymphocyte activity or macrophage activity or biologics. Now we also have drugs that are used in gout. We have drugs that are used in acute gout, which are the NSAIDs that are on the other side, the left side of your screen. And we have glucocorticoids, which we covered in previous lectures. And we have chronic treatment of gout. That can involve colchicine. Remember, that drug shows up again. Uricosurics and xanthine oxidase inhibitors. We'll talk about those more later. Acetaminophen is sort of this other drug that sort of straddles everything. Is acetaminophen an anti-inflammatory agent or not? In my personal opinion, I would categorize it as an antipyretic and analgesic medication. I don't classify it in my practice as an anti-inflammatory agent, but admittedly, it does have some anti-inflammatory activity.